A very good afternoon to all of you. On the YouTube platform of Uttar Pradesh Rajarshi Tandon Open University, Prayagraj, Uttar Pradesh, India, myself, Dr. Ravind Pratap Singh, faculty of Biochemistry School of Science at UPRTU. Dear students, today I am going to discuss history and scope of biochemistry. Under the umbrella of life sciences, we have so many disciplines like geology, botany, biochemistry, biotechnology, microbiology, bioinformatics, environmental science, etc. Biochemistry is one of the most important discipline under the umbrella of life science. It is just fusion of biology and chemistry. It is the chemistry of life by using different chemical reactions, different biological systems such as cells, tissues, organelles and other biological systems. So, what is biochemistry? Biochemistry is the study of chemical processes that comprise living things, systems, the chemistry of life and living matter. Biochemistry can also be described as science concerned with the chemical constituents of living cells and with reactions and different processes they undergo in different cells, tissues, organelles and other biosystems. The word biochemistry is derived from bios, meaning life. The metabolic processes are studied under this branch. It is just a fusion of biology and chemistry, already I told in my introduction, and it is the chemistry of life. Biochemists are physical and chemical principles to explain biology at a molecular level. Basic principles of biochemistry are common to all living organisms, maybe plant system, maybe animal system. The lifeless organic molecule with appropriate complexity and properties make a living system. The basic life processes or chemistry remains broadly the same, whether it is an unicellular microorganisms or the higher organisms, I mean multicellular organisms, maybe human or plants. Life is nothing, just it is order of thousands of different chemical reactions which occurs in tissues, cells, organelles and biosystems. In other words, chemistry is the logic of all different type of biological processes or phenomena. So, biochemistry and their types, general biochemistry, plant biochemistry, human, medical as well as medicinal biochemistry. It involves the study of biochemistry of autotrophic organisms such as photosynthesis and other plant specific biochemical processes. Human, medical or medicinal biochemistry, medical is related to the treatment of illness and injuries, medicinal means related to the medicines. This is the typical structure of animal cell with different cell organelles. Like nuclear envelope, nucleolus, nucleus, centrioles, Golgi body, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, mitochondria, lysosomes, etc. This is the structure of plant cell, already showing different type of cell organelles, Golgi body, rough endoplasmic reticulum, nucleus, nucleolus, chloroplast, cell wall and ribosomes, vacuole, peroxisome, cytoplasm, etc. As we know, there are some differences between animal cell and plant cell, like chlorophyll is present in plant cell, whereas it is absent in animal cell. How does biochemistry impact on us? So, we have some headings like medicine, agriculture, industrial applications, environmental applications, biochemistry in agriculture, the chemical processes leading to metabolism of protein, carbohydrate, oils, vitamins and minerals apart from secondary products from plants such as gum, mucilage, oleoresins, terpenes, essential oils, phenolics, etc. are very important for farmers and end users of quality of crop and end products of the plant. The genetic engineering and biotechnology are the most important powerful tools, which involves a great deal of biochemistry for the crop improvement such as transgenic crop as well as transgenic animals. What is the importance of biochemistry in agriculture? So, we have several importance of biochemistry in different disciplines in agriculture. It can be better managed with better varieties and practices to improve the variety of plants and animals. Nowadays, we are having different hybrid vegetables, fruits and other transgenic animals as well. Transgenic plants which are highly yielding, nutritionally more desirable and self-fertilizing can be synthesized such as transgenic plant and transgenic animals. Pesticides which are more specific, biodegradable and non-toxic to the animals can be formulated. So, this is the history of biochemistry during 17th and 18th centuries. Important foundations were laid in many fields of biology. In 19th century, Sladen and Swan proposed cell theory, Mendel's proposed study of inheritance, Darwin's theory of evolution. In the year of 1838, Euler synthesized urea by the use of an ammonia. Urea was the first organic compound synthesized first time in the laboratory under the supervision of Euler. In 1857, Louis Pasteur proposed fermentation, importance of enzymes in different biological processes. Edward Buckner, enzymes from yeast cell include from ferment sugar to alcohol. In 1903, Newberg introduced the term biochemistry. Early part of 20th century, sudden outburst of knowledge in chemical analysis, separation methods, electronic instrumentation for biological studies such as X-ray, diffraction electron microscope such as TEMP, transmission electron microscope, SEM, scanning electron microscope, and AFM, atomic force microscope, etc. In 1926, James Sommer, proteinaceous nature of enzyme, isolation of crystallization of urease. In 1930-40, Krebs proposed citric acid cycle and urea cycle. In 1940, Lippmann told about central role of ATP in biological system. In 1953, Watson and Crick proposed structure of DNA. In 1953, again, Frederick proposed sequencing of protein. 1956, Korenberg discovery of DNA polymerase. In 1977, Sanger's proposed nucleic acid. In 1980, Snell et al. Proposed recombinant DNA research or recombinant DNA technology. So, this is the simple structure of DNA having different adenine, thymine, cytosine, and guanine. These are the different nitrogenous bases. This is the double helical model of DNA. Here we can see these are the sugar phosphate backbone, these are the nitrogenous bases, and these are the major groups, this is the minor groups, and we have different nitrogenous bases like adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine, and uracil. Here guanine is bonded to cytosine and thymine is connected to adenine. So we have different areas under the biochemistry, structure and function of biological macromolecules. Metabolism are of two types, anabolic and catabolic processes, molecular genetics, how life is replicated, regulation of protein synthesis. We have so many significance or importance of biochemistry. It is useful in the treatment of animals and man to fix the need of food and nutrients in animals so that malnutrition in population may be avoided. By the use of biochemistry, we have different applications in pharmacology and drugs. Preservation of fruits, vegetables, and other biological entities to storage and processing of food materials, it is very much beneficial. In agricultural sector, plant breeding and genetics is based on biochemical mechanisms of genes. In nutrition and care of cattle, cows, and buffaloes, metabolism of different food nutrients are studied with the help of biochemistry. Various problems of biology and medical science can be solved. Nutritional deficiency diseases like malnutrition, balanced diet, and other energy requirements can be supplemented to improve the quality of starch through modification of regulatory enzymes, assessment of nutritional quality of starch, protein, carbohydrates, and other biomolecules. To enhance the nitrogen fixation in the plants, it is also much beneficial. So, this is organization of life. We have different points like elements, simple organic compounds known as monomers. Macromolecules known as polymers are giant molecules, supramolecular structures, cells, tissues, organelles, organisms, and other different life forms. So, this is the simple diagram, range of the sizes of different objects studied under biochemist as well as biologist. Here we can see this is the atom, this is the C60 molecule, protein, lipids, flu virus, mitochondria, this is the red RBC, red blood cell, animal cell, pollen grains, and plant cell. So, these are the different relative sizes of different things. Again, here we can see human height, length of the nerve and muscle cells, chicken neck by unaided eye. We have different microscope like light microscope for the visualization of nucleus, especially most bacteria, this mitochondria, and we have electron microscope for the visualization of very small things like viruses, ribosome, protein, lipids, small molecules, and atoms. So, we have different type of elements. we have some elements of life. All elements are arranged under the Mendy periodic table. So most abundant and essential elements for all organisms such as carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, sulfur and hydrogen. Less abundant essential for all organisms, we have some elements like sodium, magnesium, potassium, calcium and chlorine. In trace levels essential for all organisms, we have manganese, iron, cobalt, copper and zinc. In trace levels essential for some organisms, we have chromium, molybdenum, boron, aluminium, gallium, strontium as well as arsenic. Important compounds and functional groups. So we have some organic compounds like alcohol, aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acids. This is the thiol group. These are the amines. We have three types of amines: primary amine, secondary amine, as well as tertiary amine. We have some functional group in organic compounds. Like this is hydroxyl group, this is acyl group, carbonyl, carboxylate, sulfhydryl, amino group present in proteins, phosphate, and phosphoryl group. So we have phenyl ether, ester, amide, phosphate ester, and phosphoanhydride. So these are the different organic compounds. Many important biomolecules are polymers. We have different biomolecules like carbohydrates, proteins, nucleic acids, lipids. So we have some chemical formula functions of these biomolecules. We have monomeric or polymeric units, and we have some examples. Here in case of carbohydrate, they are made up of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen atoms. They are the main source of energy. Their monomeric unit is like glucose. We have some examples: glucose, fructose and galactose, sugar, starch, potatoes, pasta, etc. In case of proteins, they are made up of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen as well as nitrogen elements. Due to presence of nitrogen, proteins are different from the carbohydrates. And we have monomeric units like amino acids, because the amino acids are the building blocks of proteins. And these are the sources of proteins like meat, poultry eggs, beans, soya nuts, peanuts, butter, enzymes, etc. We have nucleic acids. In nucleic acids are made up of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, as well as phosphorus elements. And we have monomeric unit nucleotide in case of nucleic acids. And we have polymer nucleic acids, two type of nucleic acids, DNA and RNA, deoxyribonucleic acid and ribonucleic acid. Here we have two type of nucleic acids. The next is lipids. They are made up of primarily carbon and hydrogen atoms. They store energy and make up biological membrane and waterproof coverings. And here especially they are made up of fatty acids and glycerol, and we have some examples like fats, oils, waxes, membranes. So carbohydrates and its types, we have different sources of carbohydrates. Here we can see. So carbohydrates are different types like monosaccharide, disaccharide, polysaccharide. In case of monosaccharide, we have glucose, fructose and galactose. In case of disaccharide, again it is of three types: maltose, sucrose, lactose. In case of polysaccharide, again three types: starch, glycogen, cellulose. So these are the different carbohydrates. Again here we can say these are the different steps, or you can say machinery of carbohydrates, like sugar, here carbohydrates, glycosidic bond, monosaccharide, cellulose, polysaccharide, oligosaccharide, hyperglycemia, hindrance, energy, aldehyde, epimer, triose, amylopectin, starch, hexose. So these are the different parts under the carbohydrates. So this is the structure of carbohydrates. Here we can see this is the long structure. We have two monosaccharide structure. One is glucose. In glucose, aldehyde group is present, whereas in fructose, ketonic group is present. So this is the long chain structure of this is the ring structure of this is the structure of again carbohydrates. We have glucose, galactose, fructose. Here we can see in case of glucose, we are having an aldehyde group, and in case of galactose, again we are having this group, fructose, we are having ketonic group. So, all are having same molecular formula, that will be C6H12O6, but all are different structurally. So, proteins and its structure, we are having different sources of proteins like meat, seafood, poultry, grains, beans, dairy products are good sources of protein. So, again, structure of proteins, we have different amino acids. Amino acids are the building blocks of proteins. Here we can see these are the different amino acids: alanine, phenylalanine, leucine, tryptophan, aspartic acid, methionine, arginine. So, we are having different amino acids, they are the building blocks of protein. And in case of protein, we have different type of structure. This is the primary structure of protein, this is the secondary structure of protein, this is the tertiary structure of protein, and this is quaternary structure of protein, which are very complex in nature. Here, in case of amino acids, we are having two terminal, N terminus and C terminus, and when two amino acids are connected to each other, then there is a liberation of water molecule, and finally, both will be bonded by peptide bond. So, this is peptide bond between two amino acid molecule. So, again, we are having different functions of proteins in immunity, immunology. We are having different immunoglobulins in immunology. All are made up of proteins. We have antigens and different molecules, antibody, and here. So, antigens and antibody are very important biomolecule under biochemistry. Again, we are having different structure of proteins. This is the primary structure of proteins, which is linear in nature, and just it is connected by amino acids. Here, we are having secondary structure. This is the regular substructure. It is little bit different from primary structure and having some little bit complexity. In case of our tertiary structure of protein, here it is the three-dimensional in nature, and this is very complex structure of protein known as quaternary structure. So, this is very complex. Again, lipids and its types. So, lipids, again, they are biomolecule like fats, oils, waxes. These are the different sources of lipids. They provide energy for cells, cell structure, insulation. Lipids and proteins composed of cell membrane, cholesterol gives cell membrane flexibility, and they have a structure having two parts like head and tails, head cholesterol, tails of fatty acids. We have a monomeric unit of fatty acids and polymeric unit known as lipid. This is the structure of lipid having two head, hydrophilic head and hydrophobic head. Hydro means water, philic means loving, and phobic means repelling. So, hydrophilic head attracted by water molecule, whereas hydrophobic tail repelling the water molecule. So, this is the classification of lipids and the membrane lipids classification. Membrane lipids, we are having four types: phospholipids, glycolipids, sterols, arachibacterial lipids. In case of phospholipids, again it is of two types: glycerophospholipids, sphingophospholipids. In case of glycolipids, again two types: galactolipids, sphingoglycolipids. Again, in case of sterols, there is no division: arachibacterial either lipids. So, this is the structure of lipids. This is the glycerol molecule, this is the fatty acid molecule. By the condensation of fatty acid molecule as well as glycerol molecule, these of water molecule, we have triglyceride molecule, and again by the hydrolysis of water molecule, we have again fatty acids. So, there is a conversion of glycerol and fatty acids into triglyceride molecule, and again it is vice versa. So, next is nucleic acids and its structure. So, we are having two type of nucleic acids: DNA and RNA. DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid; RNA, ribonucleic acids. So, these nucleic acids are made up of nitrogenous bases. We are having different nitrogenous bases. We are having pyrimidine bases as well as purine bases. In pyrimidine bases, we have cytosine, uracil, and thymine, uracil present in RNA and it is absent in DNA, whereas thymine present in DNA and absent in RNA. So these are the pyrimidine bases, and we have purine bases. Under purine bases, we have adenine and guanine. So adenine, guanine present in both DNA molecule as well as RNA molecule. So these are different components of nucleic acids, and this is the structure of thymine, this is the structure of adenine, guanine, cytosine, this is the structure of uracil, and here we are having sugars and phosphate, and this is the phosphate, this is the ribose. So this is the structure of DNA and RNA. Here we can see DNA having double strand, and in case of RNA it is made up of single strand. So this is the double helical structure of DNA. It is different from the RNA. Okay students, this is all about history and scope of biochemistry, and if you have any confusion regarding history and biochemistry of the topic, then in next lecture I will discuss later again. You can put your query in box. Thank you. Thank you so much.